to have a little mix of genders in these things.
Amen. I'm for it. Yes.
What you will find on the YouTube debates, very unfortunately, is men debating men. There are very few women atheists who engage in
Is that right?
Yes.
There are a lot of women Christian scholars on YouTube. I didn't know there were no women atheists. That's fascinating.
Louise Anthony is the only one I've seen, but I hope to change that.
Good for you. Huh.
You said that the resurrection is unique in all of history. And I think as a Lutheran growing up in Bismarck, North Dakota, in the 50s, I believe that true. Unfortunately, I'm sure you're aware, and I would ask you if you are, of the hundreds of different gods and goddesses that were prevalent in religions at this point of time in the first century who died, were buried, rose again in 3 days. So what makes yours unique from all the Dionysus or all of the others, that meme, which Richard Dawkins defines as almost like genetic, it's a cultural piece, a meme. The meme of death, resurrection in 3 days is incredibly prevalent throughout Greco-Roman world.
Which so one, can you give me one example?
Dionysus.
What, tell us the story,
well,
briefly.
I'm not real good on remembering names, as Nicole will just attest to, because I forgot hers 2 seconds later. there were hundreds of religions that had gods and goddesses in Greco-Roman times where they died and came back. It was a theme that's present through many, many. If you just do Greco-Roman gods, you will find that. So my theory is that, and in Mark, he doesn't mention the resurrection. And we believe that Mark is written about 70 AD after the destruction of the temple.
Mark doesn't mention the resurrection?
Mark doesn't. Mark ends with an empty tomb. There are a few verses after the end of Mark that most scholars agree were appended later on.
That's
because there's earlier versions of Mark that have been found without those verses.
This is the end of Mark. I just stuck it up there.
Those last verses were...
This is not the last questionable verses. Verse 6 is right there. That's in the widely accepted. The part that's debated starts at verse 9. So, the resurrection is in Mark.
Have you read about those other
mythologies? Actually, I have. Yes, I have.
So,
yeah.
what makes yours unique?
I went back and read many of those stories, and the story of Jesus is very different. My favorite is, I won't get the name right, it's the Egyptian god. I think it's Isis.
Isis
who's
one of
the... Osiris.
Oh,
yeah.
Cool.
He dies, and somebody cuts him up into 12 pieces, and they get scattered around, and they go back and they gather up all the pieces and put them together by magic, but they're missing a very important part of him that makes him fun in bed. So by magic, they do some kinky thing, and I think that's a lot different than the Jesus story.
That one, I will admit you, is pretty unique.
But, I have gone back and read those stories, and the thing I find is actually the claim there are hundreds of those stories. I can't find them. There are things like the corn god who buried in the dirt.
If you give me your email, I'll be happy to.
The corn god is buried in the dirt, and with the spring he comes back up again. I'll quickly grant you those are there.
Hercules, for example, his father was Zeus. He had a human mother, so he was immortal, I guess. And after he died, there's belief that he became divine.
And the Mithraic religion has several of them, and that was a religion that the Roman soldiers had at the time in Palestine.
Krishna is an avatar of Vishnu, Lord Krishna.
Yeah, you don't have a death and resurrection there.
No, but it's just God becoming man.
Yeah, my encouragement is go read the stories. When I read them, I find they're actually quite different.
Is it pertaining to this?
Yeah.
Okay, go for it.
It's kind of like the counterpoint of what she was talking about. Consequently, if there are other religions that do have a resurrection myth or something like that, there are multiple and almost universally considered animist religions both located in early Asia and North America up until the Spaniards arrived, that have a creator. And they strongly believe in the creator as the master of all the lesser gods that come after them. And if you dig deep enough in the roots of those cultures, you can find those guys. So how do you, I guess...
Like Hercules, for example? Are you saying Hercules is like that?
No, I'm saying animist religious, not organized polytheism. I'm talking about like Native Americans, where they have the sky god, they have their creator god.
Yeah, I think the Native Americans, at a seminary I took a course in early American history, and I think what they said is actually the Native American religion is actually kind of lost. A lot of the modern religion in the Native Americans has been synchronized, and you know, there's all the tribes had a little different version too, and those just got nuked out. So it's hard to know really what they believe.
I'm just saying that the majority of the oral tradition comes all the way back to this beginning god, this creator god. How do you reconcile that with your beliefs, if it's kind of a universally held theme within humanity?
Well, I mean, it's kind of obvious if you said something else made everything, that's going to be a god. So I'm not really sure what your point is. You're saying they believe that there is a creator god. Well, of course, if you believe there's a god, he created everything.
It's something that permeates all of humanity throughout
cultures. Right, right. For example, what causes thunder and lightning? Obviously, the gods do. And so they have all these thunder gods. Thor, I think Zeus is a thunder god too. And then they find out, oh, you know, thunder is not made by the gods. It's made by electrical differences. Same with earthquakes. The gods did this. It's just human nature we don't know, we're ignorant, so God must have done it. And we learn through science, oh, there's natural explanations for these. So.
Yeah, you want to come on up?